I have known Ogunjobi for several years. We worked together in the Tracy for several years, 89, 1991, 1992, till we captured the Cup Winners Cup. And since then, we have been very close. The family and that of mine, very close. I said one thing yesterday, that it is better you die young when the ovation is loudest. Taiwo Ogunjobi lived a fulfilled life. Taiwo Ogunjobi was forthright and straightforward. Taiwo Ogunjobi would never compromise the truth. When my organization was in turmoil, it was Ogunjobi that stabilized the supporters club that became the best in the whole world. For us in the supporters club, we will continue to remember him. And what has happened, has happened. I want to implore all of you to search your conscience. What do you want people to say after you are gone? People can say several things, but do good things. If you do good things, goodness will follow you. If you like to do bad things, the reward is there. Taiwo Ogunjobi was always there to do the good things. He touched several lives, those that I know. But I don't want to take much of your time. I want to use this opportunity to invite the first vice president of the Nigeria Football Federation, Barrister Seyi Akinwunmi, to please come here. We must do a honor for this great son of Nigeria. Somebody who crisscrossed the whole world and made all of us proud. Apart from being a footballer and administrator by excellence, he made all of us happy. A lot of things were said about him, but now, what do we do? Chief Ogunjobi was a national icon. And therefore, Vice President, I and you will go to that casket and you will help me to decorate his casket with the national flag. He is a national hero. We are no longer mourning him, we are celebrating him. So I plead with you to emulate Taiwo Ogunjobi, because he couldn't for any reason hurt anybody. Taiwo, rest in perfect peace, and may the Lord bless this country with people like him. God bless you all.
May God grant you eternal rest in Jesus' name.